Happy Saturday afternoon, everyone. The musical scrapper here coming from the east coast of Canada, where there is a storm going on, but not here in Moncton. About an hour and a half away, it's in a full-fledged snowstorm. Roads shut down, things canceled, and here we have sun with cloudy periods, and it's a beautiful day. Cold, but beautiful. You can't find the 100 count? Mindy, I got them on Amazon Canada, so I would think Amazon in the U.S. would have them, I would think. It shows them as not in, they come up as not in stock, but it took about a week or a week and a half. Like, I pay for them anyway, and it says we'll send them as soon as we get them in stock, and it was about a week after that that they, yeah. Well, maybe it took 2 weeks total, anyway, for me to get them. So, Mindy, if I have them, she needs some. Oh, really? Oh, that's too bad. Well, it's very strange that Canada has them and you guys don't. Anyway, so I thought before I start coloring, better get the arm of my chair down or my fingers get caught underneath the desk. Sorry, trying to get comfortable here. Okay, so I thought I'd show my eye stencil order. Small order this time because I'm trying to stretch out my money a little bit. Hey, Paula! Nice to see you. So here's my splot stencil. So if I have the urge to add any splots to my work, I have a way of doing it. Oh, dang it, my mouse batteries are low. Oh, right now, I think I have a set in here charged and ready to go. Oh no, they're in my... Okay, well, if I lose my mouse, I'll have to get up and get my batteries to... Usually I have quite a few hours left before I have to fill them. Hey, Linda. Just a moment. I'm going to zoom in one more zoom, I think. Because my coloring page is smaller than that. Oops, wrong way. There we go. So this is a bad butt stencil, as I call it. Please ignore any fruit flies that fly across the thing. I tied up my garbage that had an apple core in it. Oh, they seem to come back to life every time I get an apple core in my garbage. Oh, could be just left over from that, Paula. Yeah, Pauline is here now, which is Paula and Eileen. Oh, dear. So that's one of the stencils I got. I love it because it has the doesn't have the square edge on it. Then I got this Patty one. The one that looks like a sunflower in the middle. And, of course, the free one, which is a great... That'll be the size of my ovals from my mini jelly plate set, so that's cool. Oh, I'm going to show this one last because I love this. This one's my favorite stencil. And then I got this stencil. It's similar to one I have, but not exactly. It's similar to the one I used to do this book cover with, and I love it. So I got that one. All right. right. Oops, sorry. I got my chat going the wrong way here. Just trying to move you guys over a little bit. Okay, so. So get that one. Now this one I love. This one is another, it's by the same, by the same artist who did this splat one. Designer is Andrea O'Donnell. She's a professional makeup artist and body painter. Winner of the first prize at the 2011 and 2009 Fabric Body, Fabac, whatever, body paint competition. She is top notch, accolades, jeez Louise, top notch accolades as well as extensive training in a myriad of makeup and body painting categories. So once again, her name is Andrea O'Donnell. There's your picture. And so this is her stencil. So here's the basic outline of each butterfly and dragonfly. And then there's also the matching pattern part that goes with each of those sets of wings. Isn't that cool? Love this stencil. You see a face? Oh, here? What? I see a man running. Face upside down. On the butterfly stencil? Or this one? This stencil. Oh, right here! Right here, Eileen? Right there. Two eyes, his nose. I don't see his... Oh, do you see that as his mouth? I see that as his mouth. Two eyes, his nose, a mouth. Okay. I see it now, Eileen. That's cool. Cool. But yeah, love that butterfly stencil. So... Alright, so what did I do with my coloring image? One moment, please. There it is. Got lost. I need to find something to put underneath this to color on. Oh, I guess I can use this. So, I downloaded this nice teacup to color. Okay, she said, no, what I saw was, she sees a big face. She sees a bigger face. I guess because I see that other face, and now I don't see the one Eileen sees at all. Very true, Linda. We are a very creative bunch. So I was just looking around for something I wanted to color. So I found this coffee teacup, I should say, I guess, really. do a little more of a close up here. And let's see if I need to autofocus again. There we go. It should work. Okay. So I think I'm going to start so that I don't get, because my eyes, so that I don't get the steam mixed up with my background. I think I'm going to start with some steam. And so I'm going to use a light gray for that. So I'm going to start with my super tips here. Cool, Eileen. Very cool. Uh-oh. Oh, I was going to say the cover doesn't want to fit on, but it goes on the other way. Silly girl. Silly girl. All right. I hope my head doesn't get in your way, you guys. Oh, I guess it's not going to as long as I do it this way. Yeah, exactly, Linda. Oh, especially when it's kind of drawn funny like that one is. Because this one is going like this. That's really strange. Oh well, I can fix it when I... Uh-oh. I think I need to take my glasses off. I really need to get... I need to find my reading glasses. I have no idea where they went. One goes here like this and it stops there. Trying to make it as much one line as I can, because it'll make less, fewer. Lines in the marker. If you pick up and start again with the marker, it'll make a line. So the more you can make it one fluid motion, the better it will be to be. Take away those lines. Oh, yes, Claire and Bunny's birthday is today. All right. Hi, Mayo. Linda May. And her last name starts with O, so I call her Mayo. So, Paula, are you coloring along here? This I printed offline, so if anyone wants to color along, you can just find it in Google Images, print it off, and color along with me if you want. That would be fun someday to do a coloring book page together and see how everyone's vision is different. Okay, now thanks, Linda. Yeah. Let's see. What color would be nice? I think a nice royal blue for the cup, or a dark blue. Oh, maybe this. Oh, I like this blue. It's almost kind of like a denim blue. Or, oh, there it looks. It looks on my screen a lot brighter blue than it is. It's more of a, it's a dark blue, but it's more like a softer royal blue instead of a, like there's the, I'll show you the difference. The one on the right is the dark royal blue. They almost look the same on screen, but they're not. Oops. Oh gosh, now I don't know where it took it from. Eesh. It is a free one, Eileen. There was no watermark on it. Here, let me get the link. You guys, I think I still have it open. Eileen, can you make sure my links are open, please? Here's the link. Oh, actually, I can probably give you a better link than that. Hold on. Oh, okay. All right, hold on. Okay, try this one. Oh, see if that link works. Welcome back, Ella. Okay, you're welcome. Good, good, good. Glad it worked. Pam, nice to see you. Hey, Sherry. Oh, Sharon. Excuse me, Sharon. Sharon, excuse me. Sorry about that. So I'm just coloring an image I found on Google. Just googled coloring pages for adults and found this image. Thought it was cool, so I thought I'd color it. And it's also something that I thought I could use on a journal page. So that was another reason why I decided to do it today. Hi, Ange! No, it's Sherry, not Sharon. I said Sherry first, and then everybody else was saying Sharon. So I thought I got it wrong, so I switched to Sharon, but it's actually Sherry. It's Eileen's fault. She called her Sharon. All Eileen's fault. Sorry, Sherry, with a Y. So I'm using my Crayola Super Tips on the background, and then I will be going back and using my Prismas to add some. Maisie. It is all Eileen's fault. All Eileen's fault. Uh-oh. Where'd it go? There it is. Okay, I think I'll just leave the cover over there because it's going to get lost. Sorry, my head's likely right in the middle of the screen. All right, those. Okay. Eileen. Oh, Lynn. Lynn said Sharon first. Oh, wow, Lynn. So for those who have come in, Eileen can probably, actually I can share the link. Here's a link to the page that I printed it off from Google. If you want to print it off and color along, and then we could share it on Twitter. Everybody's different take on the... on the page. Uh-oh, looks like we had a minor problem with chat there. Oh, Ange, poor Ange doesn't have a printer. I didn't realize that. Ange, keep your eye on it open at Walmart. Or Staples even, because I know my cousin and I got a really good, it was just a printer. You know, not a scanner all in one or anything, just a printer, really good printer for $30. And it was an HP printer. My cousin, I've seen it since too, for about $30. And we got it about 5 years ago because I wanted to use it just for school stuff, because we can claim, we could hand in receipts for printer ink if we printed stuff at home. So I wanted to have it separate for just all my school stuff, and I sold it since. But it was an HP printer. It was $30, and it, my cousin still uses hers, and it was like 5-6 years ago. It was a really, really good printer. Yeah, there you go, Eileen. That's a good idea. Oh, I know, Linda. That's one thing it does. When you buy a cheap printer, it's easier to replace the printer than the ink. Especially when you get ink with your printer when you buy it. It's like, really? It's basically like getting the printer for free. This is just for, you know, for background. I will be adding shading later. Oh, they likely do, Linda. They likely do. Your printer is offline? Jillian, did you not just have an update, a problem with your router? Because sometimes that will happen if you have to reset your router. Sometimes your printer then won't find it. So you may have to put your password in your printer again. Hey, CB. Nice to see you. Hey, Terry. Oh, I know, laser printer. I really, when I replaced this Epson printer, I really wanted to get a color laser printer until I found out it was like $297 for the cartridge. I mean, granted, I know it prints thousands of pages, but still. Try not to go back over what I've already colored when I'm using these markers. Still getting lines, but I will soften out all those lines with my pencil crayons when I get to that step. I know Dee Dee doesn't use her markers for this large a space, but with it really being just printer paper, I don't want to use a watercolor. Because it would really, really wrinkle up. Although it's decent printer paper, but it's the Costco printer paper. So it is thicker than some. No email notice today. Yeah, CB, it's really funny because I only get email. I get email notices from Ange and from, I don't even get them from Dee Dee. When Barb was on Ustream, I would get email notices from Barb and from Ange. And I didn't get email notices from anyone else. So, I don't know. It's really weird. Hey, Jet. Hey, Terry. Oh, Juju. Hi, Juju. Nice to see you. Oh, really, Linda? Turkey? Oh. So, how bad is it snowing there, Linda? Because we've got sun and cloud. My sister has, in Glasgow, has seven inches of snow already today. And we've got sun. With cloudy periods and not a flake of snow. Stops at Amherst, apparently. That's what the, and that's rare. This is a really rare winter for us because usually we get twice the snow that Pictou County gets, that my sister gets. As we're usually, we're kind of the bowl of New Brunswick, except the very far north of New Brunswick, but we're kind of like the bowl, and we're right over a marshland, so usually if there's any snow in the area, it comes to Moncton usually, but not this year. No, I won't complain, but that's fine. Notice to stay off the roads, yeah. But sometimes even just a dusting of snow is bad, because then when it's really cold, it's slippery. It makes for icy roads when it's cold and just a dusting of snow. Sometimes if you have more snow packed on the roads, it's actually safer to drive. I mean, as long as it's not like 2 or 3 feet, but when it's just a dusting, it can be very slippery when it's cold. Hey, Dixie. Nice to see you. Oh, and not just cold turkey sandwiches. I love hot turkey sandwiches with stuffing in them, dressing in them. Oh, yum. Yum, yum, yum. And then turkey burgers. Oh, now I want a turkey, Linda. You guys must have bought it at Christmas time when they were on sale. Last time I went to get a turkey at Superstore, it was $47. I was like, I don't think so. And that was the smallest turkey there. It was after Christmas, but still. Oh, I love this color blue. Oh, nice, Linda. Very nice. Nice. Well, it's a good day to pull it out when there's snow in the air and, yep, make it a house very nice and cozy. So Linda, being from Wales, is Dan's stuffing or dressing like our traditional maritime bread and potato dressing, or does he do a different kind of dressing? Yeah. Oh, bread and potato dressing. Yeah. Well, Dixie, you can once it's cooked, you can cut it up, put it in freezer bags, and freeze it in sandwich-sized portions, or cut some up for casseroles. Mom makes the best turkey burgers, the best hot turkey burgers. She uses some of the leftover gravy. The turkey all chopped up, mayo, and then a tiny, a tablespoon of milk. And, of course, we have summer savory here in the Maritimes. It's a Maritime thing. You guys who can't get, not savory, there's a difference. Summer savory is the best spice for turkeys and chickens. Oh my gosh, good. You guys don't know what you're missing when you can't get summer savory. Oh, we did? Oh, okay. Grew up in a vegetarian household. Who knew? So glad I didn't. My dad was Acadian. No such thing as a vegetarian. You grow up Acadian, not in his day anyway. In Dad's house, of course, there were so many of them. 14 kids and a dad who was sick with TB their whole life. And he still lived to be 95. Figure that one out. And they grew up on whatever fish they could catch, and bologna, and ground beef. They used to collect coal along the railroad tracks because we grew up in a coal mining county. So they used to walk along the railroad tracks picking up the coal that fell off the off the train cars. That's how they would heat their house. Oh, you can get summer savory there, Eileen? Oh, cool. Never have gravy or dressing left over. Yeah, that can be the issue too, Linda. Oh, dear. Thank you. I'm going to have to go back over that black with my black Posca pen, I think. Excuse me if my head's in the way. I'm getting kind of a small area here. Oh, yuck, really? Ugh. Cool. Oh, Eileen. Not, I know a lot of places can't get Summer Savory. It is an East Coast Canada. I know, because I couldn't even find it when I lived in Ontario. I don't know. They likely have it now, do they, Paula? I like bologna. If it's cut thin and fried nice and crispy, I like it. My sister still, I don't eat it very often now, though, but my sister loves it every now and then, because, yeah, we used to have it. It actually, it's not any cheap. Nowadays, it's not even as cheap as buying sliced ham or sliced chicken or turkey. So, it's, you know, why would you buy it now when it's not cheaper? But when we were growing up, it was much cheaper than other meats. And I grew up in a small town. You know, Nebraska was about 10,000 people maybe, but we were about 3,000 when I was growing up, and you just didn't have the... Heck, I didn't even taste celery until I was in high school, I think, because it was a rare... You know, you live in a coal mining area. The ground is really great for growing green beans and yellow beans and carrots and potatoes and turnips. That's what we ate. Okay, so, oh, just up on my mouth here. Okay, now, let's see, what color do I want? Some yellow in here, I know for sure. So I think, let's do the greens, because I know I want greens, obviously. So I'm going to do the leaves in this green and this green. Yeah, Jenna. No, Paula, I just asked if you guys can get Summer Savory in Ontario now. They didn't have, when I lived up there, I never could find it. Oh, I missed a spot for blue. I see. Okay. poultry seasoning?
Yeah.
We use poultry seasoning and summer savory both. Okay, now, where else do I want this dark green? I'm not going to do the inside of that handle with the markers too hard. Okay, I think I'll do the... No, I want those to be yellow, those dots. I want them to be yellow. So I think that's all for the dark green then. Okay. Oh, no, up here. I do have some dark green, the center one here. I'm just wondering if that should be blue. I think it should be. I need to get my blue out again. Thank you, Dixie. Okay, Linda, no worries. I'm trying to see what the design is around the top. Oh yeah, okay, I see now. I have to look at it upside right to see. Okay, so it's here and here. There's going to be the light green in that other area, strip there. Try and circular, see what happens here. Just checking out the back, and it's, yeah. Yeah, but that's savory, Eileen. That's not summer savory. Summer savory is different. There's savory and then there's summer savory, and summer savory is completely different from savory. Anyone know tutorials on making a flip book? So do you mean, Sherry, by that, do you mean ones that have like pages that flip out, or you just mean a small little book for flip through like pictures and stuff? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to one who lives there. For she once was a true love of mine. CB, make, well, a tag or a postcard and make it so that it has a flavor of Texas, where you're from, what part of Texas you're from. Like we did when we did our 4x4s in Jen's swap. Oh, it was quite a few years ago. 5 years ago, maybe. I did one. I cut out New Brunswick and Nova Scotia, and I cut out New Brunswick using paper that I printed of New Brunswick's tartan, and Nova Scotia was Nova Scotia's tartan because I was born in Nova Scotia but live in New Brunswick. So, oh, okay, sorry, Eileen. Okay, never mind. Cool, Eileen. Yeah. Oh, you know, Eileen, they probably get that in because of all of the East Coasters that go down, all the snowbirds that go down to Florida. Because we would be lost without our summer savory when we're cooking chicken and turkey. Oh, now I'm singing. From Yentl. If I were a rich man. La 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 la. Yeah, we always dry. We always get, dried summer savory. You don't usually get it buy it fresh. I rarely use fresh herbs. I don't think I've ever used fresh herbs. Okay. Uh-oh. Keep losing the covers. Hold on one moment, please. I gotta take off my... I've got a good t-shirt on, so good thing I'm not using paint. Or I'd have to leave my sweatshirt on. Okay. Sorry, my watch is bothering my wrist for some reason today. I don't know why. I can't go without my watch on, so... Well, Eileen, you know what? Last time I talked about it, you know, like a year ago, nobody, maybe you weren't there, but nobody even seemed to know what summer savory was. That's why I thought you couldn't get it. No other reason. And I need an orange as well. So what? I want orange for the very center here, I think. And I think for this outside, this part here, these petals. Yeah, Linda, that's, I was trying to make it look like that elegant blue, what do you call it? Yeah, like you said, the Dutch. It's not quite as vibrant in real life as it is on my screen, but yeah. I didn't want it to look like China necessarily. It's kind of a big one, so it does kind of look a little more like pottery then. And of course, blue and orange are complementary colors, so that's going to really help the flowers pop here. Something weird's going on here. Oh, I forgot some green. I forgot some green stuff here. Darn it, I should have done that in the orange. Dang it all. Totally wasn't thinking. I wonder if I can go over it with my white paint and then go over it with orange. I don't know what I was thinking. And I missed a little blue spot here. Let's see. I wonder if I can go over it with, will this work? This is my grease. Oh, because then my, oh darn it, shouldn't have done that. Put my pastel pencil. Where are my... This is my narrow one though, so it's going to take a while for it to... There, that'll work, I think. And then I think I can go over it with the orange without it getting muddy on me. Maybe, I hope. Excuse my head if it's in the way or if I'm off screen. Just trying to get this. Might have to do another layer of white once that dries. Put it here and go back to it. All right, Now I've got two colors of yellow here. Light in between these. I think I want orange on those. It'll look better. Guess I could have waited and did those with my pencil crayons because now they're totally messed up going over lines. Okay, so then I'm going to use my darker yellow for this layer. Almost looks like a purple. Oh, it's not the orange. It almost looks like the orange. Maybe it'll dry lighter. Yes, so it should have swatched all my Crayola because they're not coloring the color of their tips.
They're quite a bit darker.
Thank you, Dixie. Ooh, good luck, Eileen. I'm sure you will do great. Please share. Eileen, you have to share your art on Twitter more often. Just saying. Because, you know, you inspire us all. But you just need to share it. You always share your digi art, but you don't share your other paper art. We need to see it. We need to see it! Okay, now these are going to be yellow. Yellow. Oh, I still missed some of my light green. And I have a little bit of blue I missed out on here. Oh, it's turning out kind of green, which I guess isn't too bad. It'll go yellow when I use my pencil crayon, though, I think.
missed my orange centers over here. Gosh.
Oh, cool, Z. Can't wait.
Missed a orange flower center over here.
Oh, my knee is aching. I have to go to the pharmacy and get more Advil. I ran out. I'm not supposed to take it with my blood pressure, but I don't think I'm doing any better for my blood pressure to be in pain. So I may as well take the Advil, right? Yeah, I would rather do a craft along or a tag along than a swap. Just we all work on kind of the same idea or concept and then share our work on Twitter or whatever. Then, and not actually do a swap, because I don't like having to get to the mail and I don't like that pressure.
I have to start working on my... Sam is off this week. I think I'm going to hire him to come over and help me with some work. Is the selling painful too? Oh, swelling. Oh, yeah, Dixie, but it's a different kind of pain. Yeah, but the arthritis pain right now is actually worse. Because the swelling pain is like an ache. It's just like a constant ache. Think of it. It's kind of like a balloon blowing up inside. So you always have that pressure on your skin. So it's kind of a pressure pain. But then the arthritis pain is an ache, but it's a different kind of ache. And of course, then there's the pain from whatever else is wrong with my right knee. That's pain, not ache. Okay, that I'm going to do with my pencil crayon. All right, so I think that's it for my marker stuff. Well, no, I should do, really should do the wall. Hmm. Any color suggestions for the wall? I want to do it a neutral. I don't really want gray. Maybe. I think I'll just do it like a beige. Not to lift my marker when I have a large space. On the background, yeah, I could do a watercolor, but like I said, this is just thin, it's just printer paper, and it'll curl up even worse than my coloring book page did last week, wrinkle up. Of course, it doesn't matter so much if I have lines on here, because then I can make it look like boards anyway. It looks like wood plaque. Right. Yeah, my Michaels carries the dilution sprays, but not the paints. Excuse me. Of course, they hardly have any. Waiting for my friend to call with the date about her Stampin' Up! Party, because someone told me that Stampin' Up! Has a really nice black and cream paper line, and I need that for my wedding album I need to make. Oh, there's a gray. I should have left the gray out. Oh, this is the one I used. Just a gray spot here. Another little gray spot. Oop. See, some of these gray spots are double. I bet if Eileen picks it, Xandra will have it, because, you know, Xandra has everything. If Eileen picks a theme. Uh-oh. Hold on. Got a gray section here that I missed. like it must be a gray spot too, right here. Yeah. Coloring on my hand now. Dang it all. Tag off. There we go. A tag off between Eileen and Z. Woohoo! I like that when Z starts a project, she can get it finished in maybe two or three streams, sometimes one. Like I'm talking about her albums or whatever. Some people start an album and it takes them like 10 streams to finish it. It's like, oh, really? Or more. I'm like, really? Z works. Not too fast, but like fast enough. There needs to be a black line. I need to get my black Posca pen out here. They missed a black line in the background. Oh no! Dang it all! Uh-oh. Gonna have to get my scissors to pick that up. Where'd it go? Dropped my marker. Where'd it go? Hello, where did you roll to, you silly thing? Oh, dang it. And it was my beige marker. One moment, please. I think I need to get my... flashlight on here so I can see. Oh, I've got white paper on the floor now. I can't find my marker. One moment, please. Oh, now I got my foot in the garbage can. Oh, good, Jean. Where'd it go? I heard it fall on the floor. I didn't hear it roll. One moment. Oh, there it is. A white marker on a piece of white paper. Hard to see. Okay. Turn my flashlight off. There we go. Oh. Hold on. Gotta move my box of Kleenex. First end, Newfoundland and New Brunswick are playing. No score. Men's Brier Canadian Curling Championships. Woohoo. All right, now, all that happened when I was looking to find my marker to add a black line right there. And that's too thick, but anyway, whatever. Now, you'll notice that the black is not smearing on this. It's my Epson printer. Can watercolor. I usually just throw the heat gun on it for a few seconds. It doesn't always need that, but thank you. Sorry, CB. Sorry. I apologize. Just a second. Let me fix this for a second. Oh, wrong way. There we go. That will help. Bunny, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Bunny. Happy birthday to you and many more. Good choice. Me? What? Oh. He does hands. Yay, and cool. In harmony. Woohoo. See, had I known that Ange sang when we were in Maryland, we would have done some duets while we were there. Yes, we would have. You're welcome, buddy. Happy, happy birthday. Now, the way this is drawn, it looks more like it doesn't look like it's the top of a table. It more looks like it's the wainscoting on a wall, but I think I'm going to cut that off anyway. When I put it on my journal page and make a table. Okay. Excuse me, please. Blowing my nose. Allergy sniffles. Nothing unusual. Because I've got too much dust around here. Okay. Now, I think now it is time to start with some details with my color pencils. Pencil crayons, as I like to call them, because I live in Canada. Not at all. Okay. I need to get a pencil, something. I don't like this box because it's five separate. Oh, I like the fact that it's divided into five separate things, but then it's kind of like, oh, where does this one belong? Where does this one belong? Where did I take this one from? Anyway, need to find a better way to store these. I think I might just buy a pencil box next time I'm in Dollarama. This was back here, but something... anyway, it doesn't matter. Okay, these are going down here, out of my way. Okay. Now, oh, okay, so let's start with grays on this gray steam. Let's see, how's this for color? That's good for the highlights. This for the medium. And that for the dark, maybe? Let's see what these look like. It might be a little too dark. This is kind of a beige green. No, I like the other one. Whoops. Okay. These have not... they came sharpened, but not the way I like them. Love my Prisma sharpener. I love my electric sharpener too, but it's not plugged in right now. Still has something stuck in it. That's annoying. Okay, gotta empty my pencil sharpener again here. Oh. Okay, just one moment, please. I have to get my pokey something sharp in here. Something still stuck in the... Where's my... Moment. There's my... Uh-oh. That didn't sound good. Something went behind my desk. Darn it all. Yeah, there's something stuck in there. Ah, there it is! Now it's cleaned out. Okay. Good. Thank you, Juju. Yes, I am going to add it onto a journal page, probably tomorrow. Means I don't have to think about what I'm going to do tomorrow on tomorrow's stream. Unless I really get in the mood to do it this afternoon. Oops, wrong end. Alright, so let's start with the light. So the lighter color goes on all the outward pointy parts. These tops of the curls and the left side of curls. Well, left. It's really the right. I've got it upside down, so it's really the left. think I need to do it on the tips, all the points. I'm going to need to have a light. Oh yes, I do mean Monday. Sorry, I said tomorrow. I meant Monday. I did mean Monday. I'm not streaming tomorrow. I should have started. Oh, I always forget that. I want to start with my medium one, not my light one. Dang it. Because now I have to go back with the light. And, that's okay. I'll do it at the end, very end. Blend. Guess I would have to anyway. Thank you, Ella. Paula Ray! Oh, Paula. Tell that person that they're talking too much. That'll solve that problem. I don't know why I've got that. Paula! Oh my gosh, that's too funny. Your art is good, but you talk too much. Really? Wow. Glad she doesn't come to my streams. Don't listen to her, Paula. Your talking tells us what you're doing, and we love that. Because you're sharing your thought process. Obviously, that person doesn't have any thought processes. Oh, sorry. Did I say that? Oh, shouldn't have said that. Right, so now I just need some dark low lights here. I'm going to blend as I go, or I'm going to forget where I've blended and where I haven't. Oh, I didn't get enough dark in that. Remember, this is just on printer paper, so it's not doing too badly with the shading here. Not that I'm the greatest, but dark. Uh-oh, I obviously missed something in chat. Well, that's no big surprise. Oh no. Thanks, CB. See you later. Miss Sunny knows what this is gonna look like when I turn it right side up, but anyway, it should look okay. with the steam as her hair. Eileen. But then I'd have to like cut out around all that steam. I would have to fussy cut it. Yeah, I don't know if that's gonna happen. You can do that for us, Eileen. Good idea. Can you imagine me fussy cutting out all that? Yeah, no. Oh, I meant to ask my sister the other day if she's been coloring her calendar pages, because I gave her a calendar, you know, a desktop calendar that had a coloring page for every day. She told me, I told her I put it in her stocking, and I said, now, if you're not going to do this, I'm going to take it back. But she does like to sit and color. I don't even know where my small scissors are. They're supposed to be in my knitting bag, but I don't think they're there. It really does. It does. You're right, Eileen. Like, this is the handle's the tassel. Could make turn the handle into a tassel. Yeah, exactly. The grad's walking away. This would be the back of their head. Cut the steam off the cup. Add the head and then use the steam as hair. Yeah, so I could cut the steam and use it on either side. Yeah, I could do it that way too with the grad facing. Or the grad's walking down the aisle. But then the poor grad has gray hair. Of course, it's in style nowadays to have gray. She suggested that a while ago, Eileen. I would have made the steam brown or yellow, blonde. I'll see, Eileen. I have lots left to color. That could be my idea for Monday. Okay. I need to sharpen these again. Just one turn, maybe. Or two. All right, so we did that one. For those of you watching the recording, Eileen is suggesting that I use this as a grad cap. Then this is her hair. Cut the steam off and separate it. Add it to a face as a grad cap. So I'm going to be adding it to a journal page on Monday's stream, my regular stream day. So you never know. That just might happen. Oh, for heaven's sakes, I'm all butterfingers today. Running off my little board here that I have. All right, I did that one already. Jean, what are you doing? What are you doing? All right, so need to finish this one. Welcome back, Z. Okay. Ready. Dark. Oops, middle one. All right, I need a little more dark where these two divide here. And light here so that it shows up. Yes, see, while you were gone, Eileen suggested that this looks like a grad cap. And then I should cut the steam off, cut out the cup, turn it into a grad cap, and use this as her hair. And I said, well, then the poor grad has gray hair. Although, dyeing your hair gray is in style now, so it could be. Definitely could be. I like this one the best, but of course it has more space to color. Need to do medium. Oh, someone's tweeting me. All right. Yay, Gary. Keep losing my little page I have here under my coloring. Okay. Getting close to done with the steam here. Who'd have thought just shading steam would take this much time? All right. Now, mist. sunlight. Oh, there, that's better. Okay, all right. Next is this one. Yeah, exactly, Paula. I'd rather you fall asleep during my stream than during your own. I'm the one who takes the proud honors in doing that. Well, I didn't fall asleep while I was streaming. I fell asleep and missed waking up to stream. Even though Sherry and Eileen were tweeting me, and I still slept through my stream time. Thanks, Paula. You just pick for this. Obviously, where it's closer to the mug is going to be shaded because you want to divide between, because it's coming out from behind the lip of the cup. So this part would be shaded. I don't know, for some reason I do have, I think I remember a lot of our shading that we learned. I mean, I only ever had one year of art, and it was charcoal and pastel, but we did learn about shading and stuff. So my light source is kind of coming this way, plus even irregardless of the light source, the cup is going to cast a little bit of a shadow on the steam that's coming out. How the information is presented. I mean, if it's sensible criticism, then like, big deal, really. It's always good to have criticism. It's how it's presented. I mean, really, if Dee Dee criticized my artwork, like how I'm shading this stream, if she gave me pointers or told me something that would work better, it wouldn't bother me at all. However, if someone who obviously doesn't know what they're talking about says it in a rude and impolite way, then it would bother me. Not as... You know what I mean? I'm all for criticism. It's all about the presentation. But I think I'm kind of sensitive to it too, because as a teacher, I know how to comment and give criticism without criticizing the person, critiquing their work. You know, you can't tell a kid, oh, that sounds perfect, or, you know, whatever, if it's not really good sounding music. But you can criticize them without, you know, oh, that was better than last time. You're doing great. You're improving. Now, we need to work on this little part here. That kind of thing. I mean, that's what I'm there for. I remember sometimes with my band, but of course I could always tell by the kids too what you're able to say and what you're not able to say. I remember there was a couple times with my band, or the choir even, you know, where they would sing something or play something, and it would sound like crap. And I would look at them and I would make a like kind of like strange face. And I was like, okay, that didn't sound very good. Let's try that again. Because I know you guys can do much better than that. Or they'll start laughing themselves because they know it sounded so bad. But, I mean... I remember once even from with my band saying, I don't know what page of music you guys are playing off, but it's not the same one I'm conducting. Anyway, they laughed. They thought it was really funny. It was funny. And I would never do that if it's their first try on something either. I would only ever do it if it's something they're, you know, we've played before and they know how to do it. Okay, I think the steam is complete. Let's turn her over and see what it looks like. Not bad, eh? You have to kind of ignore the background because the background is crap. All right, so now let's go in there. I'm not sure how this yellow, oh yeah, that I do know, because that's the fluorescent yellow. That's how that ended up down on this side. All right, so now let's get my yellows and my oranges out and ready to go. So that orange, and I think this orange, and then I need two yellows. I think I only need two yellows because there's not a whole lot of yellow. I think those two yellows will work. Oh yeah, steam, hair, whatever. Thanks, you guys. Thanks, Dixie. Thanks, Eileen. Oh, it works. Steam or hair, whichever it is. Well, my niece is graduating from university this year, but her colors are, she's at the Royal Military College, so of course their colors are red and white. But I can do a general graduation quote, I'm sure. Oh, Dixie. Oh, found an abandoned dog? Oh. Thanks, Carrie. All right, so I'm going to do the light stuff first before I do the back blue background. Oh, dang it. That broke. It's only about the second time I broke a lid. Okay. Not enough placement to do any highlighting or anything on this orange, so it's going to just get colored. just to smooth out the, even out the marker color. Oh, definitely, Dixie. I hope she decides to agree. I know it's really hard right now, Anna, but I almost always replace my animals right away or as soon as I can afterwards. Just because, yes, I'm sad, but hey, there's another animal out there that needs me. Of course, this my last ones I got from a... I don't always buy from a breeder. I usually get ones that need a home, either ones that have been found on the street or whatever, but or leftovers, secondhand pets. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do now, I'm going to go might have to use a gray. Don't know what's going to work here. Oh, for Fooey, why are my yellows? This is the first time these ones got... I hope my blades of my Prisma aren't getting, like, dull already. They still seem to be sharpening easily. Ah-ha! Funny, Mindy. Good one. ETEA. University. Oh, right, Carrie. I forgot about that. Yes, thank you. I do have to do that, I think. I mean, these pencils are new. I got them just before Christmas, so most of them, it's the first time I've used them still. But the sharpener has sharpened quite a few. Forgot that tip. Thank you, Carrie. I knew it. I just forgot it. not a whole lot of shading to do in this flower, I don't think. I mean, my eye, not a whole lot of space for it. Thank you, Bunny. Thank you, Dixie. Whoops, sorry if I'm off screen. I'm trying to do these teeny tiny little spaces in this coffee handle here. Need to sharpen this orange one because I want a good tip. Want a good point. Yeah. Kind of turned it into like paneling.
Yeah.
Everyone's doesn't mean my eye, my vision is better than anyone else's. It's just different. It could have easily been nice lined wallpaper. Whoops. Trying to remember not to hold my pencils down so close. Of course, in school, right, you're taught to hold your pencils, you know. I'm trying not to for my coloring. always mess up. Hey, Judy. Nice to see you. Thank you, Dixie. You are very kind. Your comments. You know, my sister loved my my journal. My sister, who is an artist not doing any art these days, she's the true artist in the family. Oh my god. Well, she's very musical too. She can play any percussion instrument you put in her hand and play it extremely well. And she liked my journal page from Monday the Sun one so much that she asked if she could post it on Facebook to see if it would get passed around. I'm not sure if it did or not. Yeah, I know, Dixie. I have to loosen up on the grip, but, ugh, it's tough. I find it hard anyway. Now to try and make this look round, I need to do a little more dark here on the outside. And I think I'm going to need to add some white here. Oh, wait, now maybe a really light yellow. No, I think I need to use white. I'm not sure why that's way up there. I don't know if the white will lighten it enough or not. I think I actually need some orange too on the very end. There we go. Hi. Oh, gosh, no, it's not hand-drawn. I think I have the link here still. There you go. Loosen up on my grip too. Then that takes away control. Oh, stupid fly. Okay, so... Oh, for goodness sakes. Dang it all. I have to rescue another pencil that I dropped here. May have to rescue it later. Oh, no, I see it. Fell against my color table that I got for my desk. Oh! Rest well, Carrie. Have a good nap. I think Janet's here, Lynn. Oh, Janet! She was earlier. All right. I don't know if I finished this one or not. Needs a little more color if I did. Whoops. Oh, wrong one. Picked up the wrong one. Here we go. Okay, now my two oranges go here, my two yellows go here. All right, now, okay, gotta do my greens before I do my blues. So, I need a dark and then a medium and a light for highlights. Well, that'll be my light. This can be my medium, I think. Medium. Maybe this one will work better with that light. Medium. Close to yellow. Okay, and now I need a dark. Yeah. Okay. And these haven't been finished sharpening yet. Let's do a... Oh, here's one from start. Very nice writing point there. I'm going to keep that in with my Prismas so I can use it as a sharp